All right, here's my code walkthrough for Project 2. The Road Warrior. To start off, I'm importing the infinity value from math. Although, wait, I never use it. And I'm importing the priority queue class for purposes of searching. And I'm importing the graph viz class from that was provided, as well as the edge and the node class. To start on the project, I had to create a search node class that extends the given node class. It includes the x, y, and label the values of the parent node class, along with the value for the depth, this node's current parent in the path, and the cost to get to this node from the root in the path. I then implemented a less than comparison for other.pathCost, which returns true if the other node has a lower path cost than this node. I then implemented a copy class that I used to create a copy with the new parent for using the expand method. And then we have this function that gets the node's path to the root in node names as a list. If this node is the root node and has no parent, it returns just the label. Otherwise, it returns the label concatenated with a list containing the label concatenated with the parent's get path. And then there's two helper functions I wrote, node depth and negative node and neg node depth, but which return the depth of the node and the inverse depth of the node, respectively. The negative node depth is then renamed as depth first, and the breadth and the node depth is renamed as breadth first, because that's the needed heuristic for best first search to have the same results as depth and breadth first searches, respectively. And then I defined a function uniform cost that returns the path cost of a node, which is used to implement uniform cost search through breadth first search. Then I defined a function that gets the minimum distance between a node and its goal state by getting the distance between a node and each goal state, getting the Euclidean distance between each node and a node state, and then finding which one's the lowest. And then I defined a function for the A star heuristic that returns the path cost of the node plus its minimum distance to a minimum Euclidean distance to a goal state. And then I defined the other functions as class members so that I could, for use in setting the search function. And then there's the class constructor. We make an empty set of nodes, an empty dictionary of nodes, an empty list of edges, an empty dictionary of explored nodes, and an empty dictionary of each node's children. We create a empty priority queue for the frontier. We set the goal nodes equal to the list of names of goal nodes we get passed in, and then we set the search type to none and the visualizer to graph viz. then sets, there's the function setSearch function, which takes in a string and sets self.search type to that function. According to this dictionary. And then there's the load graph from file method that's kind of important. That gets the node from a, that gets the nodes and their children from a file. We also get the edges just for compatibility with graph, with the graph visualization class. First we read in all the lines, then we get rid of all the white space, and then for each line we replace all these special characters with commas. Then we split it along commas. And then we define these seven values according to each line. Then we check if there's a node with the first name in the nodes dictionary. If there isn't, then we create, then we add it to the nodes dictionary, create it and add it to the nodes dictionary, and then add an empty list of its children to the nodes dictionary. If the second node doesn't exist, we do the same thing. Then we make a new edge. And then we, from these two nodes, X positions, Y positions, and weights, and we set its labels to the two names. And then we append the name of the other node and the weight of the path and the length of the path to in a tuple to the children dictionary at the first node's name. We do a reverse with the second node, and then we add the edges to the edge list. Then we this is getting run way too many times. Then at the end we take self.visual, we create a graph visualizer, and then load in the same file that we just loaded into the graph searcher. And then I wrote this function actions, which returns all the children of the node and their weight, and the weights of the path to get there. Then there's the expand function, which takes in a node and self for the graph it's called on. And then for each node in the actions you can take from the current node, it gets that node, gets its cost, it updates this parameters, wait, this line does nothing, I took out that parameter a while ago, so this one takes, it creates a list of updated nodes from this node, and then it takes in self.nodes. Then for each node name that is in the children, it gets the node for that node name, the calculates, finds the cost of that node from the second item in that in the tuple from node name, and adds it to the current node's cost. And then we append it to the updated nodes, create a new node with the new cost and new parent, and append it to the updated nodes. And then once we're done with all that, we return the list of updated nodes. Now we're on to the meat and potatoes here. where we take in the name of the starting point, and then we start the graph visualization first, and then we check if there are enough goal nodes for this to work. If there aren't, we return an error. We print that there's an error and return none. And then for every goal in the goal list, every name of the goal nodes in the goal node list, we tell the visualizer to mark the node with that name. And then we get the root node from the node list, from its name, and then we set its path cost and depth to 0, put it in the frontier with a cost of 0, and put it in explored at its name. Then, until the frontier is empty, we get an item from the frontier, getting the second item because we put it in as a tuple with its weight. And then if the node is in the goal nodes, we return it returns itself. We return that node if the node we get out is in the goal is one of the goals. And then if it's not, we set it to explore the current node, expand from that node, and then for each child on the node. This is just some old bug tracking node because I was getting none because I forgot I made it a tuple. And then if the child's lab if there's no items with a key of the label of the child in the explored, or the item path cost is less than the path cost of the key item in of the item at the key of child.label and of the child's label in the explored dictionary, we add the ex we add the new value for that child to the ch to explored and put it on the frontier with what the search type value returns. Otherwise, we return none. And then this is the testing driver code. We try to get from node A to N. And then we get the heuristic. Right now I have the function set to A star heuristic on a graph of 100 nodes I generated. Then once that's done, we get the path from that. We search for a path from A to N, then we get that path out from the node that we get returned, and then we reverse it so it goes from start to end instead of end to start like it normally would. And then we set the explore node from on the path from it to itself, and then we print that path, paint that path, and we print out the path and the cost, and then it waits for you to push a button to exit. Want to see it run? Oi. What do you mean? Oh. Okay. Yep. Right now it's running an A star search from A to N. And it found that the best path from N is to go from A to BH, from BH to BT, from BT to BR, then to CH, then to AF, then to BJ, then to N. That should get you from A to N in around 10,339 units. Now let's close that. There. I think I did a good job. Just need to work out how to get it to behave as FIFO or LIFO if the function is respectively whatchamacallit. So is breadth or depth, or depth first? Depth first is LIFO. Depth versus FIFO, breadth search is LIFO. And that's about all I have for you today.